We're looking at subnetting class A, and it'll be a classful subnetting arrangement in contrast to VLSM, which is variable length subnet masking, which we can look at in later tutorials. So let's have a look at what class A is about. We understand that class A would have a number ranging from 1 to 127, or 0 to 127. And 127 is actually a reserve number for loopback testing. But we say that the range goes from 1 to 127, or 0 to 127, and that class B therefore goes from 128 onwards. So identifying class A by that position there, the first number. And we also note that we have a situation where class A has a certain structure, where the first octet is a network portion, and the following three octets are all host portions. So we see that class A goes network, host, host, host. And you can see from that we have lots of host bits that we can exchange to network bits, which is subnetting. Okay, in this case we've got 8 here, 8 here, and 8 here. We can't take them all, but we can take 22 of those H bits and make them all network bits if we wanted to maximize, as we might do for serial links. But we're talking classful network subnetting, so all masks will be the same for each network that we create. Let's say we had a scenario where we wanted to find the structure or the system for 500 subnets, where we're going to take this base system, borrow bits to allow for 500 subnets. Take one network developed into 500 separate smaller networks. We know there's a formula. I always use my fingers, but the formula does go as such that we will use 2 to the number of bits borrowed. Whatever goes in there must be greater than or equal to 500. And by using your fingers, you'll just go 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Still not enough. 256 is 8 bits. 9 bits would be 512. So 9 fingers, 9 bits, 512. So I'm saying we need to put a 9 there to satisfy this equation. So 9 bits are required. We understand that what we've got is a table here showing second octet and the bit pattern there from 128 down to 1. Get rid of this formula. So we can place the other label here to show us the third octet. So previous we were talking about how class A has network, host, host, host. Well, this part here is the second host portion, is the second octet. Well, the first host portion is the second octet. This H here is our third octet. So that's what we have over these numbers. We only need to show those to show where we borrow bits. We'll do that in two parts. We'll show the networks followed by the host range of addresses. So what we'd understand therefore is that we're going to borrow right across here where we take the 128, the 64, the 32, the 16, the 8, the 4, the 2, the 1, and that's 8 bits, plus one more to make 9 in total. We need 9 bits to create those 500 subnets. And once we've done that, we're just simply going to go 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and so on. Over here, underneath the 1 bit, we just go double 0, double 1, double 0, double 1. And the pattern continues like that, 4 zeros, 4 ones, eight zeros and eight ones. What I'll do on this last line here is just show the pattern where all bits are one, and show that that's the last possible subnet, and in fact that would be the same value for our mask. Remember, a class A mask will simply be 255.0.0.0 in its default format. 255, because all ones in the network portion are designated as one, all bits are designated as one, so we get 255, and host portions don't get any ones put in them for a mask. That's our mask. In this scenario, when we borrow 9 bits, you'll see, well, we've borrowed another 8 here and 1 there, so it'll go, this will change from just a simple H octet to all Ns there. That's these 8 here, and only one of these, and which is this bit here, becomes a network bit. So that's 255.255.128. We place ones in all places under the network bits, and that's our mask. You must understand that. So what we establish now is our subnet, the very first subnet, subnet 0, is all the zeros, and that will have a value of, in this case, 10.0.0.0. It doesn't look like anything's happened, but that would be our subnet 0 with our mask of 17 bits, where the first two octets make 16 and that little one there is 17, or 255.255.128.0. The very next network would be 10.0, because that's all zeros here. These are zeros. And we have a 1 here to indicate a .128.0. And of course our mask is the same as the previous network. Moving along, we see now we have 0 in that position under 128, but we have a 1 under the second octet value of 1. So it becomes 10.1.0.0. That's this line here. This is our third network, subnet 2. Subnet 0, subnet 1, subnet 2, subnet 3. Let's just put the zeros in. And we have 1 again, but this time we have a 1 under 128. Always remember the binary counting, 0101, 0011, 00. You can't go wrong. And you'll see the pattern form. This time it's 1.128.0. The subnet 4, or the fifth subnet, will be, see, in this case we've moved from 1 to 2, this is zeroed out, and the pattern will continue. Under that, our sixth subnet, subnet 5, we have 10.2.128.0. And it continues, 10.3.0.0, 10.3.128.0, 10.4.0, 10.4.128, and so on and so forth. Just keep that binary counting going. So that's how we designate the roads when we've borrowed 9 bits, and we show borrowing across the second and the third octet, just the first bit of the third octet, which is the value 128. And that's why we see this repeated pattern. That's finding the network or subnetworks after borrowing 9 bits, starting with a system 10.0.0.0. And we'll look at hosts now.